Hello friends, welcome to Health, Music and Fitness channel. Today I'll be talking about intermittent fasting and how to make bulletproof coffee and its role in intermittent fasting. I've got a lot of requests to make few videos on fitness and the fit diet which I follow. And if you have been following my fitness journey, I lost around 40 kilos and from 104 kgs I came to 65, and during this time I took to marathon running, and that is full marathon running, 42.2 kilometers. And I learned how to train my body, and I learned how to use fat and ketones to fire up my body and take energy from fats and ketones rather than carbohydrates. And if you know this art, and if you learn this small secret, you can get a lot of health benefits by practicing intermittent fasting and using bulletproof coffee in the morning. And there are a lot of researchers and scientific studies done which prove that carbohydrates, directly or indirectly, they are very inflammatory to our system and they cause inflammation. And whenever we take carbohydrates, basically you have to know there are three types of macronutrients: proteins, carbs and fats. And the least amount of trigger to insulin is by proteins. Carbohydrates cause a lot of release of insulin in response to carbohydrate intake. A lot of insulin is released because, as I said, sugar is inflammatory to the body, and our body senses that there is a lot of sugar in our bloodstreams, and then it releases insulin from the pancreas. And pancreas basically, this sends high levels of sugars in the body, and then insulin is released to get rid of the sugars. And insulin has only one action: to get rid of the excess of sugar in the blood. And what it does is it will create fat cells, adipocytes, and it will fill those fat cells by converting this sugar into fat. And it will create fat cells, then it will fill those fat cells with fat, which is formed from carbohydrates, from sugars. And that is not a very good thing. And later on, a lot of diseases can develop, cardiovascular diseases, coronary artery disease, and many neurological disorders, that they are directly linked to excess of carbohydrate intake, like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, refractory seizures. And in fact, some studies have shown that when you take less of sugar, or if you deplete your diet of sugars, lot of things, good things happen in your body. And they have done studies in Parkinsonian patients, in Alzheimer's patients, degenerative neurological disorders. In that, they have seen a significant improvement in cognitive functions, in memory, mood, stability, and lot of other parameters once the patient is put on sugar-free diet, carbohydrate-free diet. And as such, our body does not need carbs. Only certain areas of our brain, they need around 200 grams of sugar for normal optimal functioning in a day. And that 200 grams of sugar can easily be found by our liver via gluconeogenesis. So excess of sugar that we take orally is converted into fat, and insulin produces more fat cells and fills them. And most of this fat will be deposited around our abdominal areas, in girls around thighs and glutes and other areas as well. And that is detrimental. And there is a direct link to hip waist ratio, to mortality and morbidity. So this was around few years back when I took to healthy lifestyle, and that time my weight was around 104 kilos. I will put some pictures also. And things were not working right. My triglycerides were around 600, my cholesterol was around 550, and it was a bad scene. And my waist was around 42 inches, and that pant was also tight. And in fact, I thought that I should get a new one, loose one, stitched. But then something rang inside me, and it said, "No, this is a wake-up call. instead of getting a new pant stitched, you lose weight. And then I started exercises and dieting and all those things. Now, there are certain people will just go on a crash diet or they will stop eating. That will not work out well in long run, because our body knows how to get its calories, and it will make give you a lot of craving in the night, in the before you sleep, and you will then suddenly after having fasted the whole day, at around 10 o'clock you will just wake up, eat a lot of biscuits, or you will eat something sugary, or a lot of things you will eat, and then you have done no benefit by fasting the whole day. So fasting for some time is good, but it is but natural that you cannot be fasting every day. Okay, so the short form of this, the modified form of this, is intermittent fasting, which is now the thing, and a lot of researches have been done on intermittent fasting, and intermittent fasting is equally beneficial as compared to keto diet and proper fasting, 24 hours of fasting. And so what is intermittent fasting? In intermittent fasting, we fast basically around 16 hours a day, every day. So it's a lifestyle change. And basically, if you hear like this, 16 hours a day you have to fast, it is very discouraging, and you would not want to practice intermittent fasting. How I talk to myself to start intermittent fasting and continue, and I'm still continuing for after many years intermittent fasting, you have to tell your brain that, let us say you have dinner at 7 p.m. and then you wake up in the morning at around 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. and 12 hours of fasting are already over before you have woken up. So you tell your brain like that 12 hours of fasting are over, and your target is 16 hours. So just 4 more hours. So you tell your brain just 4 more hours, and you're done with your goal for that day. And that's how I train myself. That is how I tell my diabetic patients with insulin resistance how to start intermittent fasting. And many of the patients I have successfully managed to take them off insulins and even oral hypoglycemics, and the patients are really happy that it was such a simple thing which is not given in our books. And basically in our science, we just tell the patients to eat 5 times a day, 6 times a day, take food and take insulin, insulin resistance, increase more insulin, insulin resistance, increase more insulin. But that does not work. So the answer is in the diet. So today we are going little astray from our topic. So today's topic is just bulletproof coffee. So bulletproof coffee is something, if you are practicing intermittent fasting, you can have it in the mornings. So what consists of bulletproof coffee? I'll tell you the ingredients. So you have to put black coffee, around 1/2 teaspoon of coffee in water, boiling water, and you put 1/2 teaspoon of Amul butter. You can put any butter, but Amul butter is very tasty. You can put that, and you can put 1 teaspoon of coconut oil. This is MCT, medium chain triglycerides, and rapidly taken up by our body and brain cells for energy, and they don't even think about sugars. So coconut oil is very good for the body. Even butter is good, and it causes no insulin spike, and that's the beauty of it. Now, I have talked about insulin spiking again and again in this video in response to sugar intake. So what's the big deal about it? So when you take sugars, and our body senses that there is sugar in our bloodstream, insulin is released, and insulin, as I told you, will create more fat cells. It will convert the sugar into fat and fill those empty fat cells with more fat. And when there is spike of insulin in response to food intake which contains carbs, your growth hormone hits zero. And you know, growth hormone is restorative, and it is healing to the body. It will repair their muscles, tissues, And most important work of growth hormone is it will use the sugars and it will burn the fat. And most importantly, growth hormone will burn the fat. Burn the fat and it will repair your muscles, it will repair your tissues. And that is why our elders used to say we should sleep more. In fact, now also we should sleep more, because sleep is restorative. And why is it restorative? If you think of it, during sleep we are not eating, and we are not, when you are not eating, your insulin levels are low and growth hormone goes to around 2000 times the normal value in males and around 1500 times the normal value in females. So there is an inverse relationship of growth hormone and insulin. If you take food and insulin goes up, growth hormone goes down. You fast, growth hormone goes up. So now somebody might say you will lose muscle mass if you fast or if you do intermittent fasting or you do keto diet. No, it's not true. By now, otherwise, if people have been on keto diet for years, for decades, by now otherwise they would have wasted and they would have vanished. But in fact, when you're fasting, your hormonal changes occur in your body which are restorative to your muscles. The muscle breakdown stops, okay? But you have to give calories to your body, because our body is like a machine and it needs fuel. And if you don't take ketones or if you don't take fats and you don't take sugars also, then your body will burn the fat first. First it will burn the sugars and it will burn the fat and also the proteins. Then it will take your muscles also, and then you will have muscle loss. But that is when you do extreme sort of dieting and fasting for a very long time. And in fact, if you see in most of the religions, in Islam you see there is Ramadan and they do fasting for so many days. In Christianity there are Lent days and we fast for 40 days. And in Hinduism Karwa Chauth is there and many other festivals are there where people fast. So our elders knew, our prophets, they knew that fasting is good for the body. And so this thing has been incorporated into almost all the religions and fasting. And one more thing, when you fast, your body will look for sugars. The sugar is not there. Then the body will think, from where can I get more energy to fuel the brain? Because our body, God has made in such a way that it has to sustain blood flow and oxygen supply to the brain at any cost. So then it will look for aging cells and it will burn and kill all the aging cells from the skin and from other areas in your other organs, and it will eat them up for energy. And then from where else? From the precancerous cells. And you will be surprised, in a normal person, so many cancerous cells are being formed regularly, but our immune system kills them, takes care of them and burns them. And if you're fasting, all these things are accentuated, and your body will eat up all the cancerous cells. If you're fasting, it will eat all the cancerous cells for energy. It will eat all your aging cells and use them for energy. And that is how fasting helps. And in fact, in one study, one scientist got a Nobel Prize, like if you don't give carbs to a patient with cancer, the cancer cells die. This doctor got a Nobel Prize. I'll have to search the name of the physician. And all these diseases, Alzheimer's disease, refractory seizures, and Parkinson's, and many other neurodegenerative diseases, they will improve once you put the patients on keto diet or intermittent fasting or low sugar diet. So what else to do? Once you have taken this bulletproof coffee, which contains half teaspoon of coffee in boiling water and half teaspoon of butter, Amul butter, and 1 teaspoon of coconut oil, and you stir it, and you can put 5 or 7 drops of lemon, just squeeze it, a fresh lemon, and it is very tasty and it has so many calories, and you won't feel hungry till 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. So at around 1 o'clock you should break the fast, and you can have a high protein diet with fats, and then around 6 or 7 p.m. you have your dinner. If you want to have a very good response, very good fat burning effect, you should narrow down the eating window. That is, if your eating window, now if you take lunch at, if you have lunch at 12 o'clock, let us say, and you have dinner at 6 p.m. So the eating window is of 6 hours. But if you have lunch at 1 p.m. and you have dinner at 5 p.m., let us say, then your eating window is just of 4 hours. So lesser the eating window, in that there is no restriction. You can have as much as proteins or fats as you want, and everything will be used. And in fact, your body will use more calories to digest that food between 1 and 4 p.m. or between 1 p.m. and 7 p.m. And you won't go gain weight, you will not gain fat, you will have a very good muscle growth, and your mind will be very active, you will be very fresh, as if you are high on something. And that is the effect of keto diet or intermittent fasting and low sugar diet on your brain. You will be very alert, you will be very active, and you will be surprised that your memory is improving, and your cognitive functions and your stamina is improving. And especially, like, I am a marathon runner, and if you go back into the science, sugar is stored in the muscles in the form of glycogen. Glycogen is a stored form of sugar. In the liver you will see glycogen, in the muscles. And if you are running, this sugar will be used first by the muscles, but this glycogen will be used only for around 15 to 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, these stores are depleted, and then the burning starts in the muscle. That is when your body is switching from carb utilizing mode to fat burning mode. And that is why I always tell my patients, and I also practice myself, you should never run for 30 minutes or less than that, because then we are fooling ourselves. Because during this time, you are depleting your muscles and your body only of glycogen and sugars. You are doing nothing to your fat stores. If you want to burn fat, run at least for 1 hour, and then you will have half an hour of fat burning. And also, if you want very good response, you can you should practice high intensity interval training also. Like, you are running, you jog, and you start slowly. Don't tax your body. It should not be stressful. It should be an enjoyable journey when you want to start practicing and running and weight loss and healthy eating and all. It should be an enjoyable period. It should not be stressful. So first, if you are very scared that you might fall or you might have a heart attack or something like that during running, so you start walking. You walk, and 15 minutes of running. Walk, 20 minutes of 15 seconds of running, walk, 20 seconds of running, and then again walk. Once you have attained this level, okay, and then you start jogging, and a sprint as fast as you can run. You run for maybe 10 seconds or 15 seconds, and then you continue to jog. Don't stop, don't walk, jog, okay. And this is how you have to slowly stretch your limits. The whole drama will be in your brain. Your brain will tell you, you're going to have a heart attack and your heart rate is so fast. You haven't had breakfast. There will be a hole created in your stomach and you will become unconscious. You will become hyperglycemic. No, nothing will happen to you. You can keep 2 or 3 candies or toffees in your pocket just to reassure yourself, but nothing will happen. Because your body knows when to switch to fat burning mode. And once you train your body to burn the fats, it is a very pleasurable experience to run long distance races. All of us endurance running players, like marathon runners, I also run marathons, and we can't run 42 kilometers just on sugars in our body. And there is nobody in the way holding sugar bottles and juices, nothing like that. Only in TV you will see empty stalls once you reach the stall in a marathon race. And that is the time your body uses fats, and there will be excess amount of fat in any person, and you will never go out of energy. You will never become unconscious. If your body knows how to use fats, you will not become unconscious because of hypoglycemia. Your sugar may be 50 or 60, and by definition that is hypoglycemia, but you will not become unconscious because your body is not relying on that sugar. It is using fats and ketones. And you drink a lot of water when you exercise, and because fat is burnt and fat is expelled from the body in two forms, through the breath and through the urine in the form of ketones, okay, and acetone in the breath. So if you don't drink a lot of water, your message will go from your kidneys to the brain, oh come on, less water is coming, there is something wrong going in the body, less water is coming, slow down the fat burning process, I can't handle so much of ketones, so slow down. So that is how the body responds. If you take a lot of water while you're exercising and lifting weights or running long distance races, and also not taking sugars, you will get an excellent response. And the large muscle groups in your body, like the thigh muscles, your arm muscles, the latissimus, these are bulky muscles, and they will continue to burn fat even after you have stopped exercising, like marathon running and HIIT, high intensity interval training, and bodyweight exercises and gym, because not everybody can go to gym and exercise, lift weights. Like I have a problem with my cartilage in my, I have a little arthritis, so I cannot lift weights. The synovial sheaths around my tendons, they rupture. I also had a surgery for that thing. And so, but if you can lift weights, that is one of the best ways to burn fat and to gain muscles. And once you have muscle mass, your muscles need energy, they will again burn the fat. So it has to be a balance of aerobics and anaerobic. So you walk, you jog, and you also lift weights or do body weight exercises. And and one more thing, much better than running is skipping, jump skipping, rope skipping. That will burn a lot of fat. And so that is how you should be practicing and exercising. And I'm sure you will start noticing changes in your body in 2 weeks time, and your pants will go loose, and that's an excellent feeling. I had set targets that after losing 5 kilos, I will get a new jeans or a t-shirt or something like that. I do that even now. And also, we all are humans. We tend to slip away from our targets, from our goals. And the good thing is you should always come back on the track. Don't get depressed, oh, I've gained 5 kilos of weight again and I can't do it and I should just give up. No, if you have gained weight, no problem. You enjoy your food also, you enjoy whatever you want, you like ice cream or whatever, but you come back on the track and things will be good again. And one more thing, while you're practicing intermittent fasting and low carb diet or keto diet with exercises and all, you should set a day of cheat meal for your body, because then your brain will be very relaxed. It will know, okay, on Saturday I will get aloo parathas with half fry and butter, and or ice cream. You can go and have ice cream for one meal, that is fine, not more than that. Otherwise the whole effort of 1 week will go waste if you take too many cheat meals. And life is beautiful, life is blissful, and always stay happy and try to come back on the track. If you lose the track and you are defocused, life is always good and you will get abundance and lot of chances you will get. Always use them, come back, enjoy life, and always keep motivating others also. Thank you and God bless. If you like my videos, please do like and subscribe and hit the bell icon and share with your friends also. And that's it. Thank you. Bye-bye.